choir. Let's encourage them by saying, sing choir.
Hallelujah.
Sing choir. In Jesus' name.
Jesus, you're the center of my joy. All that's good and perfect comes from you.
Amen. Hallelujah.
You're the heart of my contentment, hope for all I do. Jesus, you're the center of my joy.
Jesus, you're the center of my joy.
When I lost my direction, you're the compass for my way. You're the fire and light when the nights are long and cold. In sadness, you are the laughter that shatters all my fears. When I'm all alone, your hand is there to hold. What's his name? In the simple things in life,
yes, Lord,
yes, you're the Jesus. Music.
Oh, yes.
In the meadows and the streams,
praise
the the children, my family and my home. You're the source and finish of my highest dreams. What's his name?
It was early one morning, just about the break of day. Jesus came and he touched me, and he washed my sins away. I saw him running, I saw him shouting. About the break of day, Jesus came in my room and he touched me and he washed my sins away. I saw him running, I saw him shouting. I found no doubt about him. I tell you that
I've got nothing but the Holy Ghost, but the Holy Ghost.
About the break of day, Jesus came and he touched me and he washed my sins away. I started running, I started shouting. I found no doubt about him. I tell you that
I've got nothing but the Holy Ghost, but the Holy Ghost.
Oh, the Holy Ghost,
Holy Ghost.
Save me.
Save me.
The Holy Ghost.
Thank you.
been down in my soul.
Down in my soul.
It's a Holy Ghost show.
Holy Ghost.
Moving down in my soul.
Down in my soul.
The Holy Ghost.
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 Something about that Holy Ghost.
The Holy
Something
Ghost.
About that Holy Ghost. About that Holy Ghost, something about that Holy Ghost, something about that Holy Ghost, something about that Holy Ghost. It was said, it keeps on, said, it keeps on, said, it keeps on, nothing like it, yo. Keeps on
moving.
It keeps on
moving.
The Holy Ghost.
The Holy Ghost.
All right, praise the Lord. Let's stand y'all free. Let's give them praise. Amen. Yeah, thank you, choir. Amen. Hallelujah. Something about the Holy Ghost we can't explain. But how many of you got it? Deep down on the inside. Can you say with the choir, the Holy Ghost? Talking about the Holy Ghost. Yes, and he's moving. Talking about the Holy Ghost. And he's down on the inside.
The Holy Ghost.
Talking about the Holy Ghost.
The Holy Ghost. The Holy Ghost.
Yes.
The Holy Ghost.
Glory, glory, glory.
Hallelujah.
Yes. How many know that he's moving? Amen. Yeah. Praise the Lord. God, thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. I said God is moving. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Yes, moving, moving,
moving.
He's having a progressive God.
Moving.
Thank you, Jesus. Taking us to another level in him. And he's moving.
Moving.
He's moving.
Moving.
The Holy Ghost.
The Holy Ghost.
All right, let's give the Lord praise. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, choir. Thank you, musicians. Amen. We're going to go right into the word of the Lord. Hallelujah. The Lord is blessing. The Lord is blessing me right now. Right now, right now, right now. Amen. How many ready for word this afternoon? All right. Praise God. Let's open up our Bibles. Let's stand to our feet this afternoon as we go before the Lord. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. I'm going to ask that you would turn to the book of St. John, chapter number 14. St. John, chapter number 14. And we'd like to welcome our TV viewers. We are the King's Chapel Assembly, located 703 East Jefferson Boulevard. We are the church in the heart of the city with you in our heart, and we're happy that you've tuned in this afternoon. Thank you for connecting with us, and call up a friend, let them know that the King's Chapel Assembly Power of Pentecost is on the air. In this 14th chapter of the book of St. John, I'm going to ask that you would center your attention on verse number 22. St. John 14, we'll look at verses 22 through 27. Amen. Give honor to my wife today. We thank the Lord. I thank the Lord for her. Amen. Amen. And for my son. Amen. And for my family. Give honor to Mother Greg, who's recuperating today after hip surgery, amen? In Jesus' name. As you look at the word of the Lord in this 14th chapter, verse number 22, as you read the word silently, as I read the word aloud, Judas saith unto him, not Iscariot, Lord, how is it that thou wilt manifest thyself unto us and not unto the world? Jesus answered and said unto him, if a man love me, he will keep my words, and my Father will love him. and we will come unto him and make our abode with him. He that loveth me not keepeth not my sayings, and the word which ye hear is not, praise God, mine, but the Father which sent me. Verse number 25 says, these things have I spoken unto you, being yet present with you. But the Comforter, which is the Holy Ghost, whom the Father will send in my name, he shall teach you all things and bring all things to your remembrance, whatsoever I have said unto you. Peace I leave with you, my peace I give unto you, not as the world giveth I unto you. Let not your heart be troubled, neither let it be afraid. Let's look to the Lord this afternoon. Dear Lord, in the name of Jesus, we once again come into this holy place as we worship you and we adore you. We thank you for the songs of Zion that have been sung. We thank you for every soul that has congregated together this afternoon. I pray right now that you would use this thy servant to bring forth the word to the hearts of your people. We believe today that your word is already accomplished, is already destined according to your will, and it will prosper in every soul that you send it to. Now we pray right now for clarity of speech and understanding. We pray for your heavenly wisdom today as your word is imparted. Open up our minds to be able to receive this divine seed, and we know the word, God, will be able to germinate, and we will be able to bear much fruit. I pray for everyone that hears this word as it falls upon their heart. Let them believe it by faith, act on it by faith, and live it, God. We ask these divine blessings right now. Remember right now those that are sick and afflicted in our congregation, and not only our members, but remember today those that are everywhere that are not able to get up and be have their mobility like they would like to have, God. We pray in Jesus' name that you remember today those that have fallen. We remember today, Lord, those that have backslidden. We pray that you would rejuvenate them right now, prick their hearts to a place of repentance. Lord, it's your will that they not be lost, and bring them back into a place that they can make their abode with you, God. We ask it right now, your divine blessings, God, as we call upon you in this message. We give you thanks for it. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. God bless you. May be seated in the presence of the Lord. I'd like for you to keep your Bibles open. And as you look at verse number 26, it says, but the Comforter, which is the Holy Ghost, whom the Father will send in my name, he shall teach you all things and bring all things to your remembrance, whatsoever I have said unto you. I want you to look at the latter part, all things to your remembrance, this Memorial Day weekend. And I want to talk to your hearts on the subject. Say with me, remember the Holy Ghost. Remember the Holy Ghost. He said to bring all things to your remembrance, whatsoever I've said unto you, which means here, first of all, God has got to initially plant or give us a word in order for us to have the opportunity to recall. You can't remember anything that you never first heard. But it's very important in this time where individuals are falling away, and they're falling away from the principles of the doctrine of Christ because they've taken their mind off of the word, and they're putting their mind on tangible things. Understand, the enemy is a great opportunist. He desires today to bring about distractions. He's the author, the Bible says, of confusion. The Lord speaks here to his disciples, and in this 14th chapter, we see that he gives them comfort. He says, let not your heart be troubled. In verse number 1, he says, you believe in God, believe also in me. In my Father's house are many mansions, there are many rooms. He says, if it were not so, I would have told you, but I go to prepare a place for you. There are some questions about where he's going, and some questions about why he lets them know that right now they cannot go with him. But the Lord gives them clarity, and he says, first of all, when Thomas asks, says, we don't know where you're going, in verse number 5, he says, understand this, I am the way, I am the truth, and I am the life. Amen? Jesus is the only one that that can declare to be the way, the truth, and the life. Amen. Amen. That's right. Let's give him praise. Neither is there salvation in any other, because there is no other name under heaven given among men whereby we must be saved. Praise the Lord. He goes on and lets us know and talks about the spirit of truth in this 14th chapter. And I want you to understand, when we use terms like the Holy Ghost or the Comforter or the Spirit of the Lord, some say Holy Spirit, we're still talking about one spirit. We're talking about God. Jesus is saying, it's important for me to go away, because if I don't go away, the Comforter, which is the Holy Ghost, will not come. So Jesus finishes work, amen, as, amen, the mediator, amen, here on earth. Everybody that he needs to heal in a physical body, he walks on the earth and does that. They bring individuals to Jesus, or he goes to them. He does every work that he was commanded, and he completes every work. When he dies upon the cross, amen, he offers up his own self, his own blood, being the mediator between us and God, to be able to allow us to have reconciliation back to God. But he says, I got to go away. He says, I'm going to send back the Comforter, which is the Holy Ghost. And today when we look at this, he talks about here, Jesus said, if a man loved me, he would keep my words. He says, and my Father will love him, verse 23, and we would come, we would make our abode with him. I want you to understand today that this is why it's very important that individuals don't push out that voice that they hear. That voice, many times people argue with God, they don't even understand the one you're talking back and talking to and coming against is God. God is the one that tells you, come out from among them and be separate. God is the one that tells you, you need to lay off, and in other words, forsake the things of the world. And love not the world. And many times we think we're fighting with our conscience and we're fighting with ourselves, but understand God speaks to us through his spirit. This is why he said here, there's one sin that would not be forgiven, that's blasphemy against the Holy Ghost. Amen. The Holy Ghost is real, because the Holy Ghost is God himself. And the Holy Ghost, that's right, let's give God praise. Amen. The only hope and the only help we have is in the Spirit of God, amen, that is in, praise the Lord, the atmosphere today. One writer went on to say, the word is nigh even in your mouth. And Jesus says here that I'm going to send back the Comforter, which is the Holy Ghost, and he's going to perform the function to teach you all things in verse number 26. Understand, the teaching just doesn't come out of the sky, but you have to be a student of the word, which means you cannot and you must not be independent. You must be part of a structured church. Amen? Which means you need to find, praise the Lord, a pastor or ministry that is teaching and preaching from the Holy Scriptures. Amen? You have to understand here that the Lord said upon this rock, he said, I'm going to build my church. And he said, the gates of hell should not prevail against it. So the Lord lets us know here that I'm going away, but I'm not going to leave you like orphans. I'm not going to leave you helpless and hopeless, but I'm going to send back the Comforter, which is the Holy Ghost. Amen. He'll teach you all things, and I like this. He'll bring all things to your remembrance. He says, whatsoever I've said unto you. So the disciples, they started to understand that as Jesus walked here on the earth with them, even after his resurrection, it didn't even come to their minds that he had told them previously, before he was crucified, that he was going to get up again. Amen. But the Lord had to bring the word back to their remembrance. This Memorial Day, I want you to understand today that in the midst of your tests and trials and when you're going through, you got to know that, first of all, if you've allowed yourself to digest and to eat the word, that word is not going to return back to God void or empty, but God is saying, I'll be there for you when you go through your trials and tribulation. Amen? Remember the Holy Ghost. Thank God. How many have gone through some hard trials in the last couple of weeks here? Amen. And the Lord had to remind you who you were. Amen. I told the Sunday school class this morning, amen, the devil always loves to try to remind you what you used to be. Amen. All he could try to do is work with your past. And the man, the Bible says, such were some of you. Were, of course, is the past tense, but he says, but now ye are washed. But now you are sanctified. Amen? But now you've been reconciled back to God. It's very, very important and critical today to be able to remember what God has said to you. We're living in a time today where individuals have taken their confidence and their trust out of this word. Living in a time today because of distractions of the adversary, that the devil has his own agenda to be able to take the seed or the word or the very thought of God out of your minds. And this is why the Lord commands him here. He says, remember, the Holy Ghost is going to lead you and guide you into all truth. Jesus moves on even within this 15th chapter, and in a latter clause around verse 18, he says, understand that if you were of the world would love its own, but because you are not of the world, but I called you up out of the world therefore hates you. He said, remember, use the word again in verse number 20, remember the word that I said unto you, that the servant is not greater than his Lord. I'm so glad to know that God has got to remind us from time to time how we need to think. God has got to remind us from time to time, once again, of our identity. A God that is so loving, a God that is so considerate. Sometimes even in our own natural families, if you have any pride in your own name, and I'll just use the name, for example, Johnson as a name, you have to understand that the Johnsons got to represent something, amen? The Jackson name has got to represent something. Amen. If you're Thomas, that name ought to represent something. And whenever you're acting out of order, or out of sorts, you have to remind that individual that Johnsons or Thompsons or whatever the name may be, they don't act like that. Amen. How much more, pray? Let's give God praise. How much more should we, as the children of God, need to remember today, praise God, what the Holy Ghost has said unto us? Amen. The greatest builder up of our character and our self-esteem is the word of God. And this is why when you get this word in you and you digest and let this word sink down in the deep part of your mind, God from time to time will remind you. He said, I'll never leave you and I'll never forsake you. Amen. This is why in times of adverse conflict, it's the child of God that can rise to the occasion and have a fighting spirit down on the inside because they remember their identity. See, if you work hard not to forget, first of all, who called you, then you'll always understand your purpose in life. Many individuals today are going about aimlessly because they don't hear the voice of God. Many individuals today have an empty life because they have not set their mindset on the word of the Lord. But the Lord here is talking to the church here in this 14th chapter, and he's saying here, I'm not going to give the Holy Ghost, praise God, to the world, but I'm going to send back the Comforter, the Holy Ghost, to the church. Amen? He said the world cannot receive this because the world is not ready for this. Amen? The world does not have a mind to want to go after God and serve God, but the Lord is speaking to his disciples, his believers here, and he goes on to let them know here that if you work hard to keep my commandments, I'm going to give you a free gift. Now get this, you can't work for the Holy Ghost as a gift, but you can get to a place where your mindset is open to be able to receive the blessings that God has for you. The way God sets it up in his word here, and remember the man Cornelius, a man in the book of Acts, he was praying. The man Cornelius, a man, was of the Italian band. He was giving much alms, amen. He was praying before God, amen, on a daily basis. And the Bible says that God remembered, amen, the prayers of Cornelius, amen. This is why we're here today, because the Lord saw that he put within us a mind to want to know who he is. God put within us the mind to be able to be what we call a God chaser. Amen. God gave us a mind to want to be saved and want to read this word and remember this word. And therefore, when he brings us out of darkness into his marvelous light here, he wants to always constantly remind us, remember, amen, you're not cut from the same cloth of the world, but you have been transformed by the renewing of your mind. Amen. Let's give God praise in the house. So he says here, I've got some comfort for you, but it's in the Holy Ghost. He said here, I've got some power for you, but it's in the Holy Ghost. He went on to let them know, and we celebrated Pentecost Sunday a few Sundays ago, and he said, I want you to wait in the city of Jerusalem until you be endued with power from on high. And Jesus goes up, and about 10 days later, the Holy Ghost comes in the upper room. Praise the Lord. I can just, if we can just go back there 2,000 years ago and think about it, they were left with a promise. Amen? They were left, amen, with a word from Jesus that he said exactly what he meant. And they didn't know when exactly God would come, but they waited in the upper room with the right mindset, worshiping and praising God, and suddenly there came a sound from heaven. I'm so glad to know the God that we serve is totally dependable and reliable. Whatever God said in his word, that will he do, and he will bring it to pass. We ought to give God praise today that even though Jesus has gone up, he has given us all the authority and the power that we need to be able to navigate through this age of what I call an age of I don't care-ness. It's an age of lukewarmness. Amen. When I say lukewarmness, it's sad today that many individuals don't even have a mind to want to serve God. Amen. It's sad today when we look at this, many individuals are angry and upset with God. But the Lord says here, I'm going to send back the Comforter. And if you look further on, even within the 16th chapter, if I can just bring this point out for just a little bit because it pertains to this message. He said, when I send back the Holy Ghost in the 16th chapter, amen, of the book of St. John, he says, I'm going to send back the Comforter, which is the Holy Ghost. And what he's going to do, he's going to reprove the world of sin. In other words, there's going to be a conviction on the minds of individuals of what sin is all about. Not only will he do that, but of righteousness and of judgment. He says, of sin, praise the Lord, in verse number 9, of sin because they believe not on me. Amen, praise the Lord. He goes on, lets them know here, of righteousness because I go to my Father and ye see me no more. Of judgment because the prince of this world is judged. Amen. He says, the spirit of truth will guide you into all truth. This is why some individuals today, when they know God is speaking to them and they're not in the right place, they find themselves being irritable against God. They find themselves sort of tensing up when God is speaking to them. And they do that because the old man, amen, absolutely hates the Spirit of God. The old man, the fallen nature, is not subject to God. But God is saying here, if you can just get to a place to remember what I've said to you, you've got to get to a place to understand that his word comes to give us life and that more abundantly. Amen. God comes to bring a word of conviction, but yet that conviction is taken away when you get to a place when you're obedient to the word of the Lord. In other words here, when we look at this here, the Bible says there is therefore now no condemnation to those that are in Christ Jesus who walk not after the flesh, but after the Spirit. And this is why we love to hear the name of Jesus. Huh? This is why we that are born again, we love it when God is speaking to us. Amen. We need to be aware if we are not remembering what God has said. We need to ask ourselves, when's the last time I had a prayer and talked to the Lord? Amen. When's the last time I opened up my word and stayed in the word until we felt God talking to us? Amen. When we open up the word of the Lord and when we search the scriptures, understand God is going to tell us where we're lacking. When we look into the word of the Lord, the perfect law of liberty, God is showing the weak areas that we need to work on. Amen. He's telling us how to be strong in certain areas, and then he tells us how we need to exercise our faith in other areas. But everywhere and every way, God has a way of allowing the Holy Ghost to lead us and to guide us into all truth. Amen. Look at your neighbor, tell him, remember the Holy Ghost. Amen. We need to remember what the Holy Ghost is saying to us when we feel discouraged and sometimes we get hurt in the church. Amen. Many times individuals, they get hurt, amen, in the church and they want to run out and they want to blame the whole church, amen, the whole body of believers because somebody hurt their feelings, amen? But I believe today we need to have a thicker skin than that, because you know we're not like that out there in the world. When before we got saved and somebody hurt your feelings at school, you didn't stop going to school. And when you was going to the club and to the bar and somebody hurt your feelings, amen, in the club, you didn't stop going to the bar. But it's only in the church where people get hurt, amen, by somebody in the church, and they want to blame the whole church. They want to blame all the members. The reason why I'm not with God is because somebody hurt me in the church. But I'm saying here, child of God, you got to be better than that. You got to understand here that the Holy Ghost, amen, is not only the comforter, but he's there to allow you to teach you how to be a good soldier. Amen. Amen. God said, I'm going to walk with my believer. And amen, I'm going to strive with my believer. And I'm going to be there to encourage my believer. But you got to understand the Holy Ghost is not going to do the whole work. Amen. There's something you got to bring to the table. Amen. Amen. You got to be able to bring your faith to the Word of God. And you got to be able to bring your life to God's Word. You got to be able to bring this temple, amen, to God. Amen. God doesn't suffer for you, but what God is saying here, when I send you the Comforter, I'm going to give you a special anointing that when you go through, I'll take the heat out of the flame. Amen. Let's give God praise. Amen. Praise God for who He is. We ought to know in this time, and I'm getting ready to take my seat, that we're living in a great privileged dispensation right now, because we, if anybody ought to remember what God is saying, we've got so many blessings. We've got the Word of God from Genesis to Revelation. We've got the Old Testament and the New Testament. In the old days before the New Testament was written, amen, they didn't even have, amen, the New Testament that was there. And the Spirit of God had to come down on individuals. And God had to light on individuals and land on individuals. And they were anointed to do great and mighty works. But then the Spirit of God would go back up. Amen. But we today are privileged as the children of God. We got something that they didn't have in the Old Testament. We have God residing down on the inside. That's why we need to remember that we are the vessels of the Lord today. Amen. We need to remember today it's a privilege to be able to be a container of the Holy Ghost. And this is why you have to carry yourself in a sense that understand you don't belong to the world. Amen. As a child of God, the world is not to run over you. And the world is not, amen, to drag you around. But you got to be able to tell your own self that I belong to God. Amen. And for God I live, and for God I will die. Amen. When we look at this, he said, I'm going to give you also peace. Peace in verse number 27, I leave with you. My peace I give unto you, not as the world giveth, give I unto you. Amen. He said, let not your heart be troubled, neither let it be afraid. When you remember the Holy Ghost, you will remember that God said, I've not given you the spirit of fear, but of power, love, and of a sound mind. How many times, praise the Lord, when we're going through our tests and our trials, and the devil's trying to step on us and he's trying to squash us, we have to say, Lord, remember your servant. Lord, remember all the times that I went to the house of the Lord. Amen. Remember even David. He had to remember when he lost one of the battles and he was defeated and many men were killed. He had to get his mind together. Remember how good God was. Hey, child of God, I'm telling you today, there's something about remembering what God is saying in his word today. When we look back and remember, amen, the Holy Ghost, we are not remembering a statue or some type of memorial that is no longer living, but we remember a word that is alive today. Amen. There's nothing wrong with God. God hasn't gone anywhere. He's still on the throne. He's still reigning from above today. God is still giving out the Holy Ghost in this dispensation. And we ought to be so glad to know today that we need, when we need to be taught, amen, what God is saying. God is saying here, I will unbraid your mind for you to be able to understand the scripture. But you got to be able to sit under ministry. And you got to allow yourself to be pastored, amen, by another individual. And we even as pastors have pastors over us, amen, that pour into us so that we can pour into you. Amen. Let's give God praise in the house today. So I just want to encourage you this Memorial Day weekend to remember the Holy Ghost. God said, remember the Comforter today. He said, amen, that he'll bring all things to your remembrance. So I think we need to ask the Lord, God, what are you trying to remind me? Amen. You're trying to remind me that you are the head and not the tail. God, what are you trying to remind me? You're trying to remind me, amen, that I don't have to have low self-esteem. If I'm a child of God, I can hold my head up because God loves me with an unconditional love today. Look at your neighbor. Tell them, neighbor, you need to remember. Amen. The young folks have a saying today. You need to put some respect on it. Amen. Today, you need to put some respect on the name of Jesus. You need to put some respect on the word of God. See, when you respect it, then you recognize it. Amen. Don't you dare try to step over the word of God. When you come to God, you got to respect that he is God. He's God Almighty. Amen. God is saying to this world, world, wake up and realize that I'm coming back again. Yes, I'm giving out my spirit, but I'm only giving it out to those that are willing to receive me. He said, as many as receive me, to them gave I power to become the sons of God. This is why the world can't get the Holy Ghost. The Holy Ghost is only for the church. The Holy Ghost is only for the baptized believers in God. Amen. If you got the Holy Ghost, you ought to give him some praise today. Amen. Thank God that in the time when the devil tried to squash you, thank God a word of remembrance came back to you. Amen. I reminded him of the three Hebrew boys. Amen. They already had a made up mind in the Old Testament. They already had conviction in their mind. And when the pressure was on and the king said, when you hear this music, you need to bow down and you need to worship the golden image. Amen. The young three Hebrew boys, what did they do? They had to remember, we are children of Jehovah God. We don't worship any other gods. We will not bow down, King. It doesn't matter how many times you ask us. We do remember the word of the Lord. If you're a child of God in the house right now, you ought to thank God that you remember what God said. Amen. Many today are not privileged. Many have forgotten what God has said. And they went out there in the world and they did their own thing. Many have traveled so far away from God that they forgot, amen, the precepts and the word of God. But today you ought to thank God that you're remembering who he is. You ought to thank God that you're remembering that there's something about the name of Jesus. Amen. You ought to thank God that you got enough sound mind to remember. Amen. There's something rich about his word today. Amen. There's anything you don't want to forget? You don't want to forget the name of Jesus. Amen. There's anything you don't want to forget? You don't want to forget that the Lord said, upon this rock, I'm going to build my church and the gates of hell shall not prevail against it. Come on, somebody. In a world today where the devil's snatching individuals' minds, people are waking up not even knowing their own name, not even knowing their relative's name. All time is setting in. Amen. Lord, is everything, anything we don't forget? God, don't let me forget how good you've been to me. Lord, don't let me forget that you pulled me out of the land of Egypt. Come on, somebody. You need to remember. Amen. The fire that God brought you out of. God said, remember, it was my hand that delivered you out of Egypt land. It was my hand that parted the Red Sea. Amen. God said, remember, I was in the cloud leading you and guiding you through your wilderness. Amen. God said, I went before you. And that's how you defeated all your enemies. Tell somebody that you need to remember today. Remember, it was the Holy Ghost. Amen. That allowed you to overcome. How'd you get that good job paying good money? You remember to fall on your knees and cry out to God. You didn't get that job because you're so cute. Didn't get that job because you're so pretty. Didn't get that job because of your so-called contacts. It was the Lord that made a way for you. Come on, somebody. Give them praise in the house today. Lord, we are your people today. Don't ever let us forget. Amen. It's been by your hand you have delivered us. If we got health in our bodies, in our minds, Lord, let us know, Lord, it's not because of our exercise program. It's not because of our vitamins. Amen. It's not because of our diet. It's because the goodness of the Lord. Come on, somebody. You better remember the Holy Ghost. Remember the Holy Ghost. Encourage your neighbor right now. Tell him you need to remember. When the devil, amen, tries to back you up against the wall, you need to remember the Holy Ghost. When you're thinking about backsliding, why would you want to go back into a burning building? Why would you want to go back, amen, to the pig hole? Why you want to go back to the can't help it? The devil's hoping you don't remember, but I'll never forget how good God's been to me. I'll never forget that day when the Holy Ghost fell. Amen. I'll never forget that day when I went down in Jesus' name. I never shall forget that day. The Lord told Israel, he said, amen, before the old patriarchs closed their eyes, it was a word of prophecy. He went on to tell Moses, amen, and the other ones, no sooner than I close my eyes, Israel, they're going to forget who brought them out of the land of their forefathers. He said, whatever you do, put the word as frontless before their eyes. And sure enough, look at the word. One generation and another generation next, they forgot, amen, the word of the Lord. They were asking, what about those old stories? Amen, how our people was delivered. Amen, from Pharaoh and from Egypt. Those stories have to be told again, amen. We need to be able to stir up the gift that's within us. If we're parents, we need to remind our children what the Lord said, amen. We need to remind them of their calling. We need to remind them of their uniqueness. We need to remind them that they are holy children of God. They might be acting like little devils right now, but you need to remind them why they were created. They were created to give God glory. And you need to tell them they need to straighten up and live right, because the Lord is coming back again. You need to get in their face and let them know God didn't create you to act like a crazy fool out there. God created you to give him glory. Come on, somebody. Amen. Don't you dare forget what the Lord has done. Amen. So in my closing, I just want to say, remember the Holy Ghost. You might forget your locker combination, and that's okay. They can cut your lock off. You might forget the combination on your house. But whatever you do, don't forget the Holy Ghost. Don't forget, amen, when the Lord came by. You might have got it at church on a Sunday afternoon, maybe on a Monday morning, but remember, the Lord gave you your Pentecost experience. Amen. You might have got it on a Monday or Tuesday or Wednesday, but I don't know what day it was, but don't you ever forget it was the Holy Ghost that came out of heaven and came down on you. God said, I came to give you power today. Amen. I came to transform your heart today. So, Lord, don't let us forget this Memorial Day weekend as we honor soldiers that gave their life for their country, shed their own blood because they believed in their cause. Don't ever let us forget there's one soldier that was greater than any and every soldier. Amen. There was one captain that went down. He went down for the believer today. Come on, what's his name today? Jesus. He paid the price in his blood. But unlike other soldiers that have died, Jesus got up with all power in heaven and earth. Amen. Overcame hell, death, and the grave. How can we forget a God like that? Amen. Go back to the tomb. He's no longer longer there. Go back to Jerusalem and you can see where he used to walk. But most of all, I'm glad today, amen, that he's walking around in me. If you're glad that he's walking around in you, tell the Lord, walk around, God. Walk around in me. Lord, let me remember how good you've been. Let me remember how kind you've been. When the devil wants me not to remember your goodness and start to murmur and complain, let me shake myself. Let me remember today, Lord, it was you that healed my body. It was you that transformed my mind. Come on, somebody. Why didn't you have a mental breakdown? Why didn't you take your life? Why didn't the gun go off when you put it to your head? Because God remembered your prayer. And God said, I got a better day for you. Let's give him praise in the house. Come on down, altar workers. Yeah, let's give him praise in the house. Hallelujah. Something about the Holy Ghost, I can't explain. But I got it. He said the Holy Ghost is going to bring you into remembrance. What the Holy Ghost will do for you is give you total recall. The God that we serve today is not a God that partially blesses. See, when God does it, he does it to the fullest extent. So he'll give you a complete word that you need to go through your hardest of trials. Amen? Our God is not a halfway God. He blesses you with the total recall that you need in the time of your trial. He's a God that'll show up for you when you've been trying to fight battles all by yourself today. Let's stand all over the house right now. As AV gets ready to cue up this song here, as we give the altar call, it's time for you to remember the goodness of the Lord. The psalmist says, I would have fainted unless I had believed to see the goodness of the Lord in the land of the living. In other words, if I didn't remember to see his goodness, I would have just given up. I don't know where you are right now in life, but you need to take God at his word. Amen? If you need prayer today and if you need to be baptized today in Jesus' name, everything's ready for you right now. Amen? Come on, let's just worship the Lord in the house right now. Let's remember today that God cares about you and God loves you with an everlasting love today. Yeah, let's give him worship right now. Everything's ready right now for you to believe and take him at his word. Amen? Let's remember today that the same message that was given on the Pentecost, on the day of Pentecost, is given to believers today. That you can repent of your sins and you can go down in water baptism in the name of Jesus. And you can be filled with the power of the Holy Ghost. If you want prayer today, come on right now. We want to pray for you. Amen. If you need to be healed today, if you need to be delivered, amen. Why don't you just come on down? We want to pray for you in the name of the Lord. Remember the Holy Ghost today. Amen. You know the Lord's been dealing with you. Amen. You can't fight against the Holy Ghost. You can't fight against God and win. Yes, right now. Right now, whatever you have need of, we want to pray for you.
I've seen it move in my own life.
He said, if you have the Spirit that was in Christ, he said, I'm coming back to take you home with me. Amen. If you want the Holy Ghost, amen. You can get the Holy Ghost right here in the church. Amen. If you're not baptized right now, we'll baptize you in Jesus' name. All right, if you want prayer, just come on down.